Praise God, praise God, praise God, family. Dr. Bazemore here. This is the 21st day in the month of March, the year 2021. And we are so glad to have transitioned into a new season on the Gregorian calendar. It's also the 8th day of Nisan, the year 5781 on the biblical calendar. We know that 8 is God's biblical number for new beginnings. The month of Nisan, the biblical month, is the beginning of a new year, a spiritual year. And so we are just so excited about what the implications of this blessed day are in the body of Christ. We know that every day is a blessed day in the Lord, full of revelation, full of more spiritual meanings. And so I'm so thankful that on this day, we will continue with the book of Revelation, and we will also hear the prophetic word that the Lord has for us. I'm so glad that the Lord ordered your steps this way. Share this message, like it, that's your amen. Make sure that you're subscribed. We have videos here, messages every Sunday, Wednesday, and Friday, and whenever the Lord places in my heart and spirit to come before you with a word from him. In Jesus' name, be blessed.
And the voice I had first heard speaking to me like a trumpet said, "Come up here, and I will show you what must take place after this." So we know now that John is in the spirit. He's speaking, he says at once he was, as you move on, he starts to speak about being in the spirit, and he starts to share with us the throne in heaven. And he says someone was sitting on it, and he begins to describe what it looked like, the appearance. And he's began to speak about the rainbow, which resembles an emerald, and that it encircled the throne. And he says that surrounding the throne, there were 24 other thrones. So there's the throne and then 24 other thrones. And on these 24 other thrones, they're also seated on them were 24 elders. And he begins to speak about how they're dressed. They're dressed in white and they have crowns of gold on their heads. And he begins to speak about what's coming from the throne, the flashes of lightning and the rumblings and the peals of thunder. And he says before the throne that there were 7 lamps and that these lamps are blazing. He says these are the 7 spirits of God. So when we hear about this, the 7 spirits of God, the sevenfold spirit, we know that 7 speaks to completeness and completion. And so we know that this is speaking of the fullness of the sevenfold character of the Holy Spirit, that the Holy Spirit we know is one in, He's one. However, his essence is very numerous as it relates to the influence, especially as we think of the influence over the churches. And we just finished reading about the 7 churches. And he speaks about the throne having what looked like a sea of glass, which was as clear as crystal before the throne. And in the center around the throne were 4 living creatures in front and in back. So he's giving us so much description about what he is experiencing. The first living creature was like a lion. The second was like an ox. The third had a face like a man. And the fourth was like a flying eagle, reminding us again of the Gospels of Jesus Christ. And just reminding us that each of the 4 living creatures had 6 wings, and they covered they were covered with eyes all around, even under the wings. And day and night, the Bible says, they never stop saying, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come." And so we're being reminded right now that Revelation is speaking to us about the sovereignty of God, that God is still on his throne. He's on his throne. All things are under his control, and he knew the end from the beginning. He knows the end from the beginning. And so all that is is being experienced in the world, all around the world, John now is able to observe and interpret the things of life from the perspective of eternity. And so we need to always be thinking about eternity. We have eternal life in Christ Jesus. In Christ Jesus, we live forever. In Christ Jesus, there is no death. That means that there is a future that we're looking forward to, a future that we're being prepared for us. And so we are assured of this, that God has the victory. He already has the victory. We have the victory in Christ Jesus. And so this experience that John is sharing with us, once again, it is to encourage us, to give us hope, to remind us that God is holy. And when the worship is going on in the throne room of heaven, holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was, past, and is, present, and is to come, future. We are reminded, we say hallelujah, because we know that we have eternal life in Christ Jesus. And so we're going to be moving now into the fifth chapter, and we'll see what else the Holy Spirit will reveal to us. So as John goes on to share with us his observations in the throne room of heaven, he begins to speak about what he sees in the right hand of him who sat on the throne in the fifth chapter. He says that there was a scroll with writing on both sides and sealed with seven seals. Still speaking of this number seven, which speaks to completion, perfection. And he says he saw a mighty angel proclaiming in a loud voice, "Who is worthy to break the seals and open the scroll?" But there was no one in heaven or on earth or even under the earth who could open the scroll or even look inside it. And the Bible says that he wept and wept because no one was found who was worthy to open the scroll or look inside. But then one of the elders said to him, "Do not weep. The Lion of the tribe of Judah, the Root of David, has triumphed, and he is able to open the scroll and its seven seals." As I opened up today's message, you are reminded that we're in the month of Nisan, and the month of Nisan speaks to the tribe of Judah, and the tribe of Judah speaks to praise. And so he is saying here, "Do not weep. See, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, the Root of David, has triumphed." So we are in this time. Even now, we can be reminded of God's sovereignty, knowing that he has all things already worked out. Even before the foundation, he has all things already worked out. Then he saw a lamb, and that lamb looked as if it had been slain, standing in the center of the throne, encircled by the four living creatures and the elders. And he had seven, there we are again with seven horns and seven eyes, which are the seven spirits again of God, God sent out into all the earth. So he says in verse 7 in chapter 5, he came and took the scroll from the right hand of him who sat on the throne. And when he had taken it, the four living creatures and the 24 elders fell down before the Lamb, and each one had a harp, and they were holding golden bowls full of incense. And these bowls of incense, these golden bowls which are full of incense, are the prayers of the saints. We're being reminded that our prayers do matter. God hears our prayers, the prayers of the saints, we who are in Christ Jesus. Our prayers matter. And they sang a new song. We have so much to praise God for that we have a new song at all times. We can release a new song to God. We can praise him. We have so much in us, that we can give to God, praising him. And they begin to just praise, and the angels are praising. And then there's so much praise that's going on. He says the voice of many angels, numbering thousands upon thousands and 10,000 times 10,000, that they are encircling this throne. He wants us to see this in our spirit, to see this even in our mind's eye, these living creatures and the elders. elders, and in a loud voice they're singing, and they're saying, "Worthy is the Lamb who was slain to receive power and wealth and wisdom and strength and honor and glory and praise." And then he says in verse number 13, "Then I heard every creature in heaven and on earth and under the earth and on the sea and all that is in them singing, to him who sits on the throne and to the Lamb be praise," again, praise that tribe of Judah, "praise and honor and glory and power forever and ever." And the four living creatures said, "Amen." And the elders fell down and they worshiped. And so we are reminded that God hears our prayers. We are reminded that God inhabits our praise. We are reminded that God is worthy of all of our worship and that our lives are worship. The way that we live, that's worship. The way that we think and speak, that's worship. And he is worthy. He is worthy. He's worthy of our praise. He's worthy of our honor. He's worthy of our worship. And so we continue to pray. And as we pray, we know that God hears our prayers. So we're going to move into chapter number 6. And I hope you're following along with me. As you can probably tell, I'm not reading all of each chapter for time's sake. And I hope that in your own study time and as you are led by the Spirit yourself, that you just go back and let the Holy Spirit give you even more revelation. So in the 6th chapter, we know now that things are becoming even more vivid and symbolic. It's speaking to the seals. And we know that the scroll would only be read, opened and read after all the seals had been broken. So in chapter 6, there's a pattern of these seals that are being opened, being broken. So the 6th chapter, beginning at the first verse, the first seal speaks of the conqueror. "Now I saw when the Lamb opened one of the seals, and I heard one of the four living creatures saying with a voice like thunder, 'Come and see.' And I looked, and behold, a white horse." If you've been with, see now that the prices of the wheat and the barley are higher than usual. And so generally when we're thinking about supply, demand, and the economics, and so we can see this as famine, scarcity on earth. When we move to the fourth seal, it's speaking of widespread death on earth. When he opened the fourth seal, he heard a voice of the fourth living creature saying, "Come and see." So I looked, and behold, a pale horse. Now this horse is being described as being pale, and the name of him who sat on it was Death, and Hades followed with him. And power was given to them over a fourth of the earth, to kill with sword, with hunger, with death, and by the beast of the earth. And so we are seeing this, as I said, as you move into this this chapter, things are becoming more vivid. There's more, and becoming even more symbolic. So pale is speaking to yellowish green, this pale horse. And so it's speaking to what is happening here. And we are to just imagine this. And as we move to the fifth seal, then there's the cry of the martyrs. And when he opened the fifth seal, I saw under the altar the souls of those who had been slain for the word of God and for the testimony which they held. And they cried with a loud voice, saying, "How long, O Lord, holy and true, until you judge and avenge our blood on those who dwell on the earth?" Then a white robe was given to each of them. We're going back to the color white. And it was said to them that they should rest a little while longer, until both the number of their fellow servants and their brethren who would be killed as they were was completed. Again, God is reminding us that he's sovereign. God is sovereign. He already knows the number of those who would be killed. He already knows all things. God is omniscient. And so here, even when we think about the number 5, we know that the number 5 speaks to grace. And here are these martyred souls, and they're under the altar, and they are asking just how long, how long, how long. And they are reassured, they're comforted, they are encouraged at this time. God is good. We move to the sixth seal, and it speaks to cosmic disturbances. The sixth seal does. And he looked, and then the sixth seal was opened, and then there was a great earthquake, and the sun became black. So we go back to that color. Even though black is not really a color, as a sackcloth of hair, and the moon became like blood, and the stars of heaven fell to the earth, as a fig tree drops its late figs when it is shaken by a mighty wind. Then the sky receded as a scroll when it is rolled up, and every mountain and island was moved out of its place. And the kings of the earth, the great men, the rich men, the commanders, the mighty men, every slave and every free man, hid themselves in the caves and in the rocks of the mountains, and said to the mountains and rocks, "Fall on us and hide us from the face of him who sits on the throne and from the wrath of the Lamb, for the great day of his wrath has come, and who is able to stand?" So we know that wrath speaks to anger. And even as before, where the martyrs are being told to rest until God's appointed time, we know that vengeance belongs to God. So all things happen according to God's good and perfect divine timing. Now, though, there's this earthquake that is occurring, and there's so much that's going on as it relates to the stars and the moon and the sun. Again, this takes us back to the Gospel of Matthew, and begins to give us a description of the sky and what the sky looks like, and what the people are feeling, and how they are responding to this, anger. God's wrath is being revealed against unbelievers. Remember, now being released on the unbelievers, and so they're going through what happens when someone refuses to receive Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, their consequences of the behavior that they have. Remember, I've shared before that sins are forgiven, behaviors have consequences. So speaking about this wrath, speaking about what they're going through, but one thing that we must be reminded of, we who are in Christ Jesus, we have no fear. We have no fear. God is with us. Remember, God is with us. But because he's holy, so God cannot ignore sin. He's holy. And if we keep everything in perspective, as we're studying the book of Revelation, as we're studying the entire Bible, if we remember that God is holy, and because he is holy, he cannot allow sin. So, this must happen, and but just remember, we have the victory, and in the end, all things are restored to God's original intention. Well, we're going to be moving into the seventh chapter for this week. The seventh chapter speaks to the 144,000 sealed. After this, I saw four angels standing at the four corners of the earth, holding back the four winds of the earth to prevent any wind from blowing on the land or on the sea or on any tree. Then I saw another angel coming up from the east, having the seal of the living God. He called out in a loud voice to the four angels who had been given power to harm the land and the sea, "Do not harm the land or the sea or the trees until we put a seal on the foreheads of the servants of our God." Then I heard the number of those who were sealed, 144,000 from all the tribes of Israel. Now we see that the tribe of Judah first, and again, I just mentioned that we're in the month of Nisan, the first month of a spiritual new year, and the tribe associated with the month of Nisan is the tribe of Judah, and the tribe of Judah speaks to praise. And then we see the other tribes. So there were 12,000 from the tribe of Judah, 12,000 from the tribe of Reuben, 12,000 tribe of Gad, Asher, Naphtali, Manasseh, Simeon, Levi, Issachar, Zebulun, Joseph, and the tribe of Benjamin, all 12,000. So we are seeing here that they have to have this seal. And after I looked, and there before me was a great multitude that no one could count, from every nation, tribe, people, and language, standing before the throne and in front of the Lamb. They were wearing white robes and were holding palm branches in their hands. And they cried out in a loud voice, "Salvation belongs to our God, who sits on the throne, and to the Lamb." All the angels were standing around the throne and around the elders and the four living creatures. Speaking of four, we've heard four so much. They fell down on their faces before the throne and worshiped God, saying, "Amen, praise and glory and wisdom and thanks and honor and power and strength be to our God forever and ever. Amen." Then one of the elders asked me, "These in white robes, who are they? And where did they come from?" I answered, "Sir, you know." And he said, "These are they who have come out of the great tribulation. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. Therefore, they are before the throne of God and serve him day and night in his temple. And he who sits on the throne will spread his tent over them. Never again will they hunger. Never again will they thirst. The sun will not beat upon them, nor any scorching heat, for the Lamb at the center of the throne will be their shepherd. He will lead them to the springs of living water, and God will wipe away every tear from their eyes." Amen, amen, and amen. To God be the glory. We thank him for his blessing that is upon his word. We thank God for continuing to encourage us, prophetic encouragement, reminding us that it all ends well. He who has begun a good work in us, he's faithful to perform it. So I am Dr. Bazemore, you know I am your encouraging prophet, and the Lord allows me to speak encouragement into your lives. I'm looking forward to when he brings us back together again. God bless you. God bless you. And God bless you. Prophetic word for someone. God has you covered. Praise your way out of whatever you're going through. God inhabits your praise. Let your life be worship unto God. They that worship the Lord, worship him in spirit and in truth. God is with you, and this time of new beginnings, God is restoring you to his original intention. Go through it knowing that God is with you and he loves you. To God be the glory. Amen, amen, and amen.